feel so lucky, not just to that I get to read to you, but that I got to listen to all this amazing, beautiful music and these amazing poems. I had tears in my eyes for the last one. That was so good. And yeah, I'm very happy and grateful and excited. Thank you. and thank you, poets and players. So yeah, this is In My Mother Tongue, the name for grand piano is written. In my mother tongue, words can be feathered, which turns them into old jokes or proverbs. Owning a bird in my mother tongue is a sign of great madness. You can accuse someone with an outrageous opinion of cheeping and chirping. If you want to convey that you are flabbergasted or awed, in my mother tongue you might say, "My dear swan," which is what I think when I first hear you play. As your fingers move over the keys, I wonder what gets lost in translation between music and birdsong. Whether both soar above and need to shift between words. And then I remember, in my mother tongue, the name for grand piano is wind. When we search for our dead, even though we buried them in the ground. But the dead like to call to us from the moon. They try to spell out their wildering words in clouds or meteors. They try to wave at us through murmurations and other such alien patterns and significant moments. They do this to teach us, to make lifting up our eyes a habit. Remember, they say, once every day for a couple of minutes. The entire sky turns your favorite color, the very darkest shade of blue. And this is a poem from my book, which is called How to Extricate Yourself. And, you can buy it. And I always get really excited when I get to read from it. In front of real life people, because it came out in the middle of the pandemic, in the middle of lockdown, and so it was very sad that I never got to kind of share it in person. And so this is a poem that may be responsive to the octopus. it's called Medusa. It's also underwater world. Do not lose faith on the day you wake up with spiders instead of hair. Do not cry as you look in the mirror. Remember, they may stay, they may not. They are here for now. If you must take pains to cover your head, hide them crawling under your most elegant hat, lest people recoil from you in the streets, or don't. Remember Medusa and her snakes. She turned anyone to stone if they looked at her frightened. She was the monster and proud. All hiss, curse, and scorn, danger. And yet to think someone must have loved her enough to name half of all jellyfish, those moon-glowing blooms of floating fluorescent umbrellas and bells, after her. And then it's my final poem is called The Clockmaker's Daughter. I never knew my mother almost dropped out of clockmaking school when she had to admit to herself that there was something tick-ticking inside her. Something she had made, not by squinting through microscopes and careful attention to detail, but instead by neglect and forgetfulness, qualities they do not encourage at the Horological Institute. Boxing her tutors with flowy dresses and ponchos, she stayed on and half a year later gave birth to me, right on the due date, because I was always going to be a punctual baby. And the first time she saw my round, flat face, she smiled with relief. She knew just how to read me. She hummed along to the song of my cogs and gears as she carried me into her workshop, then propped me against the wall between her assortment of dye plates and steel files and calipers. She worked late into the night, furbishing my most important parts with a small bowl lathe, until she had polished me into something she would not be ashamed to hand in as her final assignment, an elaborate device with a steady heartbeat, the kind the room would feel empty without, a freestanding marvel with two hands and a mouth for telling the truth of time.
On one, about which I wrote. Among several differently compelling poems, this one came through as a winner for its bold but subtle simplicity. Its small stanzas, shorn of punctuation, read like an agreement to walk naked in the hinterland, simultaneously between spoken languages, between words and music, between the speakers, past and present, between the familiar and the strange. This is a poem that loves and relishes language, but points beyond it, letting the visible silence of its white space speak. The title is, in my mother tongue, the name for grand piano is Wing, and the author, Laura Tyler.